If you study the right way, study can be no more boring. Hey guys, नहीं गलत हो गया. If you study the right way, study can be no more boring. In this video, I'm going to share 5 tips which will make study way more interesting, way more fun. Hey guys, I'm Arushi and you're watching Good Vibes. In this video, I'll be sharing with you 5 tips which will make study very interesting, fun and way more productive and also way more effective. Let's get started. Let me start today's video without any delay. Let's start with tip number 1. Make a note-taking habit. Right. What you have to do is when you're in school or doing your online classes, you take out some rough notes on your textbook or any rough pages. Then after your school has like completed, you come back home, you fresh up, you just get ready, and after half an hour or 1 hour if you have time, you sit back on your desk and you write all your rough notes in fair. Now I will give you 3 simple steps. So first of all, take your rough notes in fair notes. Step 1 is you first of all read all your rough notes properly, get the concept clear in your mind. Step 2, you write them properly down from your rough notes to your fair notes. And step number 3, you like highlight them, you decorate them with sticky notes and all that stuff. So these are the 3 steps you do in studying after your school. This way you're revising whatever you did in school. Jitni bhi aapki notes bani, you write everything in your notes, in your fair notes, and they are always in your with you and also in your mind. So this was tip number 1. Let's move to tip number 2. Teach what you learn. My teachers always tell me that whatever you have learned today, if you're able to teach this the next day or the same day, that means you have learned the topic, or else you have not learned the topic. So after you have prepared your notes, just read the notes once again carefully. Now teach the topics, all the topics once. You can just teach it like this only. But if you want, like you don't want to teach it like that, you can create a friend circle where every day after taking out your notes, you can share notes, you can teach each other. For example, first topic I will teach and the second topic my friend will teach. In this way, it can be really easy to understand topics, revise them and make yourself perfect in that topic. Tip number 3 is don't learn make points. First, I was also like taking my notebook and I was there like studying with it, like completely I would learn from word to word. But then I understood that as we go in higher standards, the question answers become more and more and lengthy, and it is not possible to learn all of them at the same time. So my teachers gave me this tip. Don't learn the question answers, okay? Just make points. For example, I have a question. I take out important points, what I have to take in that question. I have to take about Sultan Iltutmish. I have to take who is Sultan Iltutmish, from where he is, what he did, everything, a basic thing that what I have to include. And all these points I have to remember. So when I'm in exams, I don't need to write the answer word to word. I just need to take the points in my brain and in my mind, and I have all that ready. I just need to write them in my own language. So in this way, your answer will also not be wrong, but it would be easier for you to recall it and understand it more easily. Tip number 4 is correlate studies with your daily life. Now, why are we studying? Are we studying for exams? No, we are studying to be a better person in our life, to understand something of our life. So whatever you are studying, you need to implement them in your life. You need to correlate it with your life. For example, you learn about MLAs and MLCs in your civics textbook. So when you come back home, you get to know, make a list of all your MLAs and MLCs. Get some information about them. Who are they? Where they work? What do they work? And maybe you may get a chance to interview them, like I did once. So in this way you can easily correlate your life, your studies with your life. So this is a really good solution to make your studies more interesting. Let's get to tip number 5. So this is the last tip of the day. DDB, day database. In this, what you do after you have rested, you come back at your home and you make your day database. In this, you make 3 points: study, enjoyed and rested. So how many hours you study? Don't mention your school hours. Just how much time you study, like you made notes, you taught each other, like that. So for example, 2 hours. Then how much you enjoyed. Enjoyed means not in your like schools just here after the school. Yep. Every minute you enjoy, you include here. So I enjoy and finally rested. I'm not talking about to include your sleeping at night. I'm talking about how much you rested in the day. For example, you slept early or else you slept in the afternoon, so that much time you rested. So you make a database. If you follow all these four tips which we saw earlier, you will notice some changes in your database. You will notice that your studying time has increased. Your enjoying time is on the level, whereas your resting time during the day is decreased. That means you're getting like stronger, healthier, and more interested in studying. So make sure to follow all these five tips and soon you will see improvement in them. Please drop down some good comments down. And thanks for watching. Bye.